Well, week 42 has come and gone with quite a few items of note. Damon Lindelof pulls an Orsi. More movies based on toys, a follow-up on our Neil Gaiman story from last week, and cosplay. First up, animation pioneer Lou Scheimer has passed away at the age of 85. His list of credits is extensive. For those of us who grew up in the 70s and 80s, it's our childhood here. I mean, The New Adventures of Superman, Fantastic Voyage, Aquaman, The Batman, Superman Hour, Sabrina the Teenage Witch, Fat Albert, Star Trek, Shazam, Space Academy, Tarzan, Flash Gordon, Ghostbusters, He-Man, She-Ra, Brave Star. Lots of projects that had great impact on a lot of kids. He was considered one of the good guys in the industry, and he will be missed by a great many people. Now, a follow-up on last week's story about Neil Gaiman's Neverwhere being banned at Alamogordo High School in New Mexico. English department teacher Kathy Wallace has responded, and Gaiman posted it on his Tumblr site. Basically, this is all much ado about nothing. The complaining mother, Nancy Wilmot, is focused on one particular passage in the book that doesn't get as graphic as she makes out, although it does get suggestive with a certain four-letter word used a few times. Wallace calls it a knee-jerk response, and the English department doesn't agree with the school board's decision to pull the book. Now, like a lot of other people, we want to make sure you understand we think it's fine that a parent is involved in the student's education. Personally, I think the world would be a lot better off if more parents were more involved in every aspect of their kids' lives. And I'm not going to throw stones at Ms. Wilmot. I know what it's like to be accused of being a bad parent. But there are ways to handle things, and there are bad ways to handle things. Just saying. And now some positive news with regard to Mr. Gaiman. His lost comic strips from the 1980s have been collected in a digital edition from Knockabout Comics and the company Sequential. It's a digital iPad app. Neil Gaiman's Lost Tales, available for free through the iTunes as a fundraiser for Malaria No More UK. The collection features collaborations with people like Brian Talbot, David McKean, and others. Some of Gaiman's original notes for Sandman. And for every download between now and December 31st, a donation gets made to Malaria No More. We'll leave a link to the book in our show notes. Casting news. Josh Brolin is in talks to join Jurassic World, along with Bryce Dallas Howard, Ty Simpkins, and Nick Robinson. Still no details on the plot, although the report in Variety says Robinson and Simpkins would play brothers. Michael Bay, attacked by a man wielding an air conditioner. Two brothers accosted the director, demanding money, and then swinging an air conditioner unit at Bay. This was in Hong Kong during production of Transformers 4. Early reports said Bay had received minor injuries to his face, but later statements from both Paramount and Bay himself say that's not the case. He ducked. The production team behind Elysium is being sued for theft of intellectual property. Writer Steve Wilson Briggs is making the claim that Neil Blomkamp's film is a direct ripoff of Briggs' script Butterfly Driver, which has similar themes and characters, and to which the production had access, according to Briggs, because he posted the entire thing on TriggerStreet.com as part of a script competition. Given how most people feel Elysium was a pretty generic paint-by-numbers film, this isn't likely to go very far. Now, the other film that fends off its share of lawsuits, Avatar, sequels 2, 3, and 4, begin shooting October 2014. That's according to star Sam Worthington, who let it slip during a radio interview with Australian station Nova FM. Hasbro did it. Now Mattel is getting into film production. They've launched Playground Productions. Through this new studio, Mattel plans to exert a little more creative control over its brands, which include Barbie, Hot Wheels, He-Man, Max Steel. The first project, Team Hot Wheels, The Origin of Awesome. An animated 22-minute origin story in the spring, followed by 11 2-minute shorts in the summer, and a 74-minute direct-to-home video film in the fall. Awesome. There's also a new live-action Max Steel movie in the works over at Dolphin Entertainment and Open Road Films. Sci-Fi has announced a second season of Heroes of Cosplay. You can comment or not as you see fit. And you remember back when Evil Dead reboot was the hot topic of conversation, everyone was wondering if Bruce Campbell would ever come back as the original Ash Williams. Well, we've heard about Sam Raimi working on a script for Army of Darkness 2, or Evil Dead 4, depending on how you count. Now we learn that Campbell, at Wizard World Nashville, has confirmed he's ready to come back to the franchise. No deal is in place yet, but you combine Raimi working on a script, Campbell saying he's not too busy now, showing up after the credits of the reboot, and now this news, all we can say is groovy. And finally, following in the footsteps of Roberto Orsi, Damon Lindelof has left Twitter, at least for now. This is after quite a few people took to the social media site to compare the ending of Lost to the ending for Breaking Bad. Rather harshly, Lindelof apparently had enough. Now, speaking of Twitter, we're there, and we're going to try something new. If you want to comment on any of our shows, just use the hashtag SciFiForMeTV and let us know what you think. Or you can leave a comment on the video on YouTube or find us on Facebook. Leave us a note there. Also, check out Sci-Fi For Me Radio. That's our podcast over on iTunes or through the RSS feed and our main site, scififorme.com. Don't forget to subscribe to our feeds. Share us with your friends. And we'll be back next week with more headlines on Week in Review.